Hey guys and girls, how's it going? And welcome back to another episode of the Age of Adventure with myself, Lewis. Hope you're brilliant, having yourself a great day as always. We're basically going to be carrying on today with what we did in the last episode. So I started by making this crucible furnace in my vat, and we're looking to get molten gold, and I already have a little bit in there. If we have a look in here, I've got it up to 1,700 degrees. And I'm starting to get loads and loads of gold from it. Now, I only need four bits of gold, four gold bars, for each piece of golden silk. But we can store it in a fluid tank. So I thought, well, if I get a load of it, and I got some in here, I got eight in here, which is enough to make two of my golden silk. I thought it'd be a good idea to throw a load in here so that I can store it. And we do that with a ladle, because I tried with a bucket and it didn't really want to do much. So, yeah, unless I can do it like this. No, but if we shift click with a ladle like that, it doesn't look like it's in there, but if you go over the ladles, there's 144 by 144 millibuckets, and then you can go and shift click a fluid tank and it puts it in there. So I thought I would get a load of it, because it doesn't look like it actually turns into a solid or anything like that. So if we keep doing this, then we'll be able to get a load of this spare molten. Oh, I got an unknown golden blend. Golden dust. Oh, very nice. So yeah, we can just move these over into here, so I have a spare load of gold, because all of the mariculture kind of necklaces and bits and bobs like that, to make the better ones, you need the molten gold. And I don't want to keep having to get this guy up to that temperature, because it takes a really, really long time to do that. So if I can keep producing the goods, I'll be happy with that. So let's go over and grab a little bit more gold, because I've got my miscraft dimensions now for getting ore, so ore's not really that much of a problem anymore. It might not look like I've got much, but I can just go dig some up. So let's go take a few more. This will give us another four ingots. Now, one thing you can do with this as well is you can use the ladle to pick up the juice, the old juices, and you can place that into a, you can get like a ingot cast, and you can make ingots that way out of it. So it's a good way of doubling your ingots, I guess. And I didn't actually think about that. I didn't even know you could do that, which is kind of cool. Have we got any more in there? I think we might have. Got one more in there, yeah. Let's pop that in there. And it seems like the hotter this gets, the faster it melts as well, which is kind of cool. So let's grab a couple more. There we go. So we've got 21 ingots worth of gold in our fluid tank at the minute. And once this guy cooks up, we should have two more. There we go. All right, so I think that's going to be enough. You know, it's going to stay up at that heat for some time, but I don't really need it to anymore. So we can leave it like that as it is, and if we need some more, we can take more. But we've got our ladle, which is good, and I think I'm going to pop that inside my golden bag of holding. So we're sorted there. And in here, we've got eight ingots worth. So let's go and grab some string and give this a try. And then we'll make a magic mirror. Yes. Doesn't that sound cool? I'm excited. So let's get some string. Oh, I've got string. Good stuff. Derpity derp. Let's go and put this inside our vat and see if we get some golden string. I'm excited for this. So let's pop this in here. Poof, there we go. We'll put two in there, I guess. And hopefully this will use up the whole lot and we'll get golden string. Yeah, there we go. You can see it's just done that. Let's give us one and two. Brilliant. So we got two golden silk. And this will allow us to make all the different types, I think. So we can make some of these guys. Now we've got the bracelets and we've got the necklaces. And you can see from here, they're made of different things. So that's the one with the golden thread. Some of these will say, oh no, those one. If we go to necklace in here, like there, and look at this, it says it's made with wool. And then these guys are made with golden thread. I think the golden thread better. It must be, mustn't it? Yeah. And with these, we can add the pearls. And if we add the pearls, we'll get ourselves a necklace. So this is where it becomes fun. And I think there's a different amount of pearls for different things. So if we go back to golden, we can see that the bracelets require three of the pearls and the necklaces require a lot more than that. So I wonder what's better. I guess in that it has to be the necklaces are better. They require more of the golden pearls. Or it might just be the fact that it's a necklace, so you'd think it's going to need more pearls, isn't it? So, and at the minute, we've got enough to make ourselves a bracelet of most types. As far as the pearls go, I think it's just more colour preference, really. I don't think it actually makes much of a difference. So let's just grab up all of these. I think those are still sand. Yeah, that's still sand. Let's pop that back. There we go. And we'll grab that one. Is that one done? No, that's sand as well. Cool. And we need 3 bits of sand. So let's grab 3 bits of sand to fill these back in. There we go. And I think we're looking good. So let's put those in there. Oh, I haven't got a brown pearl yet. Awesome. I haven't got one of those either. A purple pearl. Nice. And that. So let's decide on the one that we want to wear. And I'm thinking gold because, you know, if you're gonna do the golden thread, you might as well go all out. And I am pretty baller, I must admit. So, coming from a British guy, it doesn't really sound great, but believe me, I definitely have skills. So let's look at our golden guy here. So we need some golden silk and 3 golden pearls. So let's put this together. So like this, and this gives us our unworked gold pearl bracelet. All right, cool. Now we need a type of anvil, a mariculture anvil, I believe, which is a blacksmith's anvil, which requires some nether brick, it requires some brick construction blocks, and some burnt bricks. And remember, all of these require some lava and such to be placed in here so that we can do all of the stuff that we need to do. So I think I'm going to have to go and grab some more lava, and that's going to be the first point of call. And then I might go and see if I can get myself some nether bricks. And one of my ages does have a load of nethery stuff in it, doesn't it? Because we found the one that has all of that in it. And I'm loving the miscraft at the minute because it's making it a lot easier for me to prepare myself for the nether, which is going to be brilliant. So I'll be right back, guys. I'm going to get some more bits and bobs and I shall see you in a sec. All right, so I've gone and got myself some lava from around here somewhere. There's a little lava pool just over there, so I filled that up and I got 16 buckets worth, which is good. I'm gonna grab some of this as well, so let's get a load of netherrack because we can cook this up into nether brick, which is gonna be fairly handy. So we'll take a load of it, I think, just stock up a little bit. And I submit, I love my nether age. It's the best age. It gives me all the stuff that never has without being bad. Although I haven't got the blazes, but we have got another age that has blaze spawner, so I guess we'll go there at some point. So let's make our way home and we shall cook some of this up. We only need a little bit, so we just need to cook up, what, 4 bits, I think. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's throw in a bit of charcoal. There we go. And we'll get that cooking. Let's throw all these guys in here. And I managed to get some more ender pearls as well, which is quite nice. So they can go. They'll go downstairs, actually, because they're in my little area downstairs. Now, we are going to need some more bricks. So let's get our clay. And we'll grab all of this as well. And we'll give this a beating. Good stuff. And this is going to need some furnace thing as well. So let's pop that in there. And we'll give it a couple of bits of charcoal. Good stuff. And we'll get this. So we need all this for our anvil. And we also need the blacksmith's hammer as well, I believe, so we can beat it up. So let's have a look. That's the one, the blacksmith's hammer. So this requires 3 burnt bricks and 2 nether. Oh, wow, we're actually going to need more than that, aren't we, then? We're going to need a few more. We need 8 more. Let's grab those. And they can go in there. So we've got enough to make one of them. Kill. And we might need a bit more charcoal in there now. Okay, right, so we got 5. Let's go start this doing its thing downstairs. And I think I might need more clay, so I might need to make a clay run as well. But we can pop this down. This has got all my lava in it, so I can go there. And my bouquet. Let's throw some lava in here. Cool stuff. And we'll throw in all of our bricks. Nice. Cool. All right. So I'm gonna take a quick break and go and get all this stuff sorted because I'm gonna have to make a few clay runs and bits and bobs, some boring stuff. So I'm gonna go and do that, and I'll be back once we've got all the bricks that we need to make this, and then we'll do some blacksmithing. All right. So I think I've got most of the stuff I need now. The last couple of bricks should be cooking right up now. Yeah, there we go. So let's put all this together and see if it works. So it was something like that, that. And that, there we go, 1 blacksmith's anvil, And then there was the hammer. Let's check the hammer out. So the hammer was that. Cool. Alright, so let's just pop this down here, I guess. And then we'll use this. Now, we have to, like, smack it a load of times for it to work. But if we pop it down there, we can do this. And we can repair this. So over time, this guy is going to take durability damage. Oh, there we go. Yeah, over time, it's going to take durability damage. And we can repair it in our anvil. But obviously, our hammer's going to take damage as well. So if we take it out now, you can see that it's 34% worked. So we can keep doing that. So let's keep beating this guy up. I think if I just spam click it, it'll probably work. There we go. And you do this for pretty much all the jewelry, which is kind of cool. Hey, there we go. All right, so we've got our gold pearl bracelet made with golden silk. And we can hold shift to display jewelry stats. So its max enchantments is 5. Elemental effect is Midas Touch, and max enchant level is 4, with max damage of 160. Alright, so, we can't enchant these all the way, we can max enchant to level 4, which is not too bad, but we need a mirror now to be able to enchant this guy properly. So let's grab a mirror. Now, there's a couple of different types. So we've got the regular Mariculture mirror, which is this stuff. And we've got the magic mirror, which requires these guys and some pearls. And then we've got the celestial mirror, which requires a never star, which is redonkulous, but very cool. And that looks like how we do. We can actually repair it as well in a regular anvil with some aluminium ingots. Nice. So how do we make this aluminium? I believe we have to do it in here to get it all up and running. So it might be worth getting this guy fired up again and doing his thing. I think that is something we might have to do. So let's break this. There we go. And we'll pop that down there. And it should start feeding from the tank. Yeah, it looks like it is. Awesome. So it's going to feed from the tank and do its stuff. So let's look in our book and see what we need to make this. So be in our... I think it's the factory, I believe it's in. To make the different types. Or this might just be about that. Yeah, it's not factory. Let's look at basic materials and processing. That looks like it. So magnesium, titanium. That's not it. So this is... So magnesium is required to make titanium, which is used in some more advanced recipes. I don't need that. Titanium is made by combining magnesium and rutil. You can either combine them in a vat or dual melt them in a crucible furnace. Magnesium and one rutil. Oh, heat resistant bottles there. Well, I've got some ores upstairs. Let's go have a look at these ores and see what we can do with them to be able to make this stuff so I can get my mirror. I think we have the stuff to do it. It's just I can't figure out how to do it. So we have bauxite, which when used gives us molten aluminium. Is that what I need? Yeah, it is. Cool. All right. That's how we do it. So we use bauxite. So that gives us molten aluminium by smelting up with a heat of 660 degrees. So if we're going to use pretty much all of that, I'm just going to use half of it. You know what? Why not? And this should give us 2 ingots per piece that we can use. And then we need a cast, I guess, to be able to cool down our ingots. So let's throw in all of this. We'll throw that in there. I'll take this guy out. Why not? And that's going to start doing its thing. Let's go back into here and see what it says about making a cast. Oh, what was that? I just saw a ingot caster. Okay, so an ingot caster. So the ingot caster simply takes molten materials and casts them into ingots. The biome will affect the speed at which it cools. It can cool up to 4 ingots worth at a time. The ladle can be used to move stuff. All right, so before we can do that, we need to get ourselves some more clay so that we can do this stuff. So let's go grab a couple more bits of clay to be able to do that. So we need 4 bits of clay. So we can turn that into the bricks and then turn the bricks into the other stuff. Hey, at least once this is all made, it's going to be plain sailing from then, isn't it? So let's pop that in there. Oh man, I think I'm out of coal and everything because I haven't been keeping up with my tree cutting. Let's cut these guys down. Oh, there we go. Alright, we'll replant these. Because we're kind. And all that stuff, you know, replanting rules, gentleman's rule. So we got that. Let's go and cook some of these up. There we go, you can have that. And the rest can just go in here. Cool. Alright, so once that's all cooked up, we'll be able to get the stuff to be able to make that. I am probably going to go to this mirror. So, an enchantment table, we need some storage bookshelves. That's different. How do we make those? Oh, so we need 5 bookshelves, some wood, and a chest to make a storage bookshelf. Huh. Well, that's kind of cool. How much books and things have we got? We got 27 books, and we need a few of those. So, let's see how much we can get from this. Let's just grab these back. And we'll try and take all of those. So, if we turn all this into here, let's see how many we can make. So, got that. And so we got a fairly decent amount. We just need a little bit more wood, I guess. That's right in that. Okay, so we got 7. And we need, what is that? For each one, we need 5. Wow. It's not cheap. This guy, is it? No. Well, maybe we'll make that at a later time. That seems a little bit advanced and technicale for me. Although it's not that bad, because we only need paper and we need some rotten flesh so we can turn it into leather, so it's not the end of the world. But let's throw that in there. I'm going to grab some more lava from here, because I don't really want it to use it all of it up. There we go. And how are we doing in here? So we got 18 ingots worth, and oh, we got some spare clay from it. Nice. So we got 18 ingots worth of molten aluminium. And once these cook up, we should be able to get our ingot caster. And then we need to use our ladle, to move the stuff into our caster. And then dependent on the biome, depends on how fast it's going to cool. Alright. Well, we're in a sea biome, or is this an ocean biome of some description? We're in a ocean biome, which I can only guess would be, I don't know, kind of cold. It doesn't really say much ocean, does it? Can only hope. But we got 2 of these guys. Let's wait for the rest of these to do their thing. Let's quickly check on our clamps as well. How are we doing? Yeah. I got to try and keep up with these guys so that we can grab as many as possible. Because once I get the different colored blocks, that's really what I'm aiming for, the different colored blocks. Once I got those, I can start doing some pretty cool stuff with them. Should we go put a little bit of music on? I think we should. Let's go put a bit of music on. Yeah. Yeah. I think Nemson's still on doing something as well. Yeah, he's off being a druid. He's off playing with his flowers, eating sushi. Alright, here we go. Let's go with cat. Yeah, a little bit of cat. There's a mod that's getting added in the next update, actually, which I've thrown in, which is really going to put a spanner in the work for all of the toast eaters out there like me, which is called The Spice of Life. Which, what that guy does, is it makes you have to basically eat different stuff. Because if you keep eating the same thing, you start losing the amount of saturation and food that it gives you. So, yeah, that could be kind of interesting. Alright, so, it's that. Oh, what is that? Oh, that's a nugget caster. Alright, well, we don't want a nugget caster. I want the other thing. Caster, let's have a look. Ingot caster. Ingot caster requires... Oh man, do we need one more? Oh, I need one more. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, right, so we got one more. I've made some more fluid tanks for putting down our stuff. Let's give this a shot. So it was these guys, probably on the sides as well. Let's do that. There we go, 1 ingot caster. And we can do 4 at a time. So if we put this here, yeah, I'll just throw it there. We can go ahead and take our ladle and shift click, and that gives us 144. So let's put that in there. Yeah, that worked. All right, cool. So we got 1 ingot worth. We can do 4 at a time. So let's take a load of these. So there's that. Oh, well, that came out quick. Nice. Let's grab some more. Keep throwing that in there. Look at it all dropping out all over the place. So that actually does it really quick. I kind of thought that would be a slow process as far as it doing its thing. Either that or we're just in a good biome to be cooling it down. You know, the ocean could be kind of cold, couldn't it? So maybe that makes sense. Yeah, look, again, loads of them. All right, so we got 6 of these. And to make our mirror, we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need 5. Cool, we've got the bits we need. The glass pane. Let's go get a glass pane from upstairs. And we'll make our mirror. Sweet. Now, I don't think this takes up the bauble slot. So that means I can use baubles. And I can use these. And I can use familiars. So that's going to be my plan of action for surviving. I think. So we need some glass panes. Let's grab some glass. And a piece of iron. Cool. Right. So that gives us our mirror. So now, if we click on it, we can do this. We can enchant. And then we put our stuff in here. So we've got rings. We've got the pearl bracelets. And we've got the necklaces. And I think the pearl bracelets are halfway. So I think the rings are basically the kind of worse of the lot. Yeah, we've got the rings down here. And these all require one pearl. So they're not as good as the rest. So if we go and try this. And I think there is a certain max enchantment on these guys. So if I put that in now, I can get up to 5 on this. Is that the max I can have? I think it is. Yeah, the next one will allow us to enchant further as well. But the max enchantments is 5 as well, so. But, yeah. Alright, let me go downstairs. Let's just go and beat on some guys quickly. And we'll get some levels. And see how this is going to work. Yes. Because I want to try and fill up all of it. So we have all the different ones. And I'm actually getting mirror damage from every time I open the mirror, aren't I? 45175. 45175. Yeah, I am. Huh. Well, we can't keep opening and closing it then, I guess. Same with the hammer, so. I wonder if I can repair. I can repair it, can't I? Let's get a couple more. And that should give us level 5. Just see if we can get that. Come on, guys. Come on, zombies. Down you come. Down you come. There we go. Okay, right, so we're level 5. Let's make our way back to the house. Upstairs. There we go. I should stop spawning now. And we'll give this a try. So if I put that there and that, I can get up to level 5. So let's go with it, see what we get, I guess. Can't have 5. Alright, so I've actually had a proper read of this Sea Witch's book, and I probably should have done that because it looks like we've been doing it slightly wrong. I thought that you just enchanted the actual bracelet, but it doesn't look like that's how it works. So I've been all over the place trying to think, well, how does this work? Like, it doesn't want to work. It's not doing stuff. There's a little bit of server lag at the minute, by the way, so that's why it's doing that. But, yeah, it seems to be having a bit of a moment, and I figured out what it is. So, if we have a look in our Sea Witch's guide, and we go back. So, this is what it says. So, while you're able to enchant jewelry directly in an enchantment table, which I can't do, I don't know why it's not letting me do that, this is not the best option, as you'll generally only get one enchantment onto your piece that way. So, instead, you should enchant pearls directly, as recommended you enchant them inside of a mirror, as they will then have a bias to a specific enchantment helping you out. With your enchanted pearls, you can then place them into a crafting grid with your piece of jewelry. The colors must match. You must then take your jewelry to a blacksmith. So, it looks like we actually have to do the enchantments before we make the whole thing together. So I did it here on a gold pearl and I got leapfrog 2. It's not bad, I guess. But it still has a use, this gold bracelet. So I can still place this on and it has what's called an elemental effect. So every type that you make, dependent on the pearls that you use, gives you an elemental effect. So if we go forward and we've got an elemental affinity. And this enchantment is entirely unique. The effect it has depends on the pearl that the jewelry is made from, listed below the effects. So black gives you like bonus attack damage. Gold gives you killing entities, drop gold nuggets. There's a lot of different things like that, so it's not bad. But let's do this. So I want to make myself another one, but I'm going to make a ring this time because this is going to be our test ring, I think. And we can make out pretty much anything we want. So we can go with a blue pearl, which could help with our diving and whatnot. So that's we've got Aqualung, which is the elemental effect on that one. So that's not too bad. And I think that's in the Sea Witch's guide. So Aqualung and bits like that are pretty good. Yeah, immune to drowning damage. So Overall, we can still do this, but I think I'm going to go with a red pearl because I like the idea of the reds. Now, to be able to do this, we need... Let's have a look. We need one red pearl. So let's go and pop this in our mirror, because apparently this is better in a mirror. And we enchant it with a level 5. There we go. So we've got step up 2. And I've already got step up, but that's fine. We'll just... demonstration purposes. Let's do this. So we'll throw this into a crafting grid. So it should be that golden silk. I think we might actually need some gold as well. Let's have a look. Yeah, we need a load of bits of gold. So let's go upstairs. See what gold we've got. I might have to cast myself some gold. Oh, I didn't realize this was so, like, intense as far as the options you have for crafting the stuff, you know? I thought it was just a simple, you make the things, you throw some random enchants on it, but you actually have a bit more control over the enchants that you can put on it, which is kind of cool. I didn't know that. So let's grab some of this. I'm going to need a few more bits of gold. So let's grab some of this. We should pop a couple of bits in here. There we go. That should do its thing. There we go. Lovely. So, we want our pearl, which is going to be this one. So, our red one. And then our ingots gives us our unworked red pearl ring. You can see it's enchanted now as well. So, if we throw that in there and we do some working on it. Ooh. Let's put these back. There we go. We give it a beat in. For some reason, I'm just getting some weird lag around it. I don't know what it is. So let's beat this guy up. And it should hopefully come out worked. Oh, did I do it? Is it fixed? I think it's fixed. Red 0% worked. Where is my thing? I'm just going to relog, guys. All right, now that we've relogged, it looks like it's doing it. We're getting the knocking sound. It wasn't getting that a minute ago. A minute ago, we gave it back and it was 0% work. So it looked like it just hadn't caught up with me putting it inside the blacksmith's anvil. But we'll keep hitting it. And eventually, we're going to have a worked ring. There we go. All right, so we got a red one. And it's got step up 1 on it. So, the ones that have the more pearls give you more chance to have more enchants, it looks, doesn't it? So, with the other ones, we need 3 of a type. And then I'm guessing with the other parts, we need more. But this has jewelry stats. So, elemental effect is Inferno. And max enchant is 1. Max enchant level is 1. And we've got step up 1 on it. Now, one thing that I want to know is whether these are actually just given to me. Like, whether the elemental affinity is actually... this enchantment is entirely unique. Because the red gives you... let's have a look. Red. Immune to fire and lava if you're wearing the red pearl ring. And it says here, elemental effect Inferno. But I don't know whether that means that's what it specifies it towards. So, I might do something stupid and try and burn myself. Just to see if that's what it's talking about. So, let's do this. And we'll pop that in there. Okay, right. So I already know that I've got step up. That's not what I'm worried about. But I need to set myself alight. Really, to test this out. Because according to this guy, if I have this, and I don't know if I do, I think this might be something I have to actually get on a pearl. I should be immune to fire and lava. So, this is stupid, but let's give it a try. Let's grab some of this. Oh, where's my bucket gone? Does it eat my bucket? Does it eat my bucket? Please stop doing this to me. Where's my bucket gone? Oh, man. Alright. Oh, I got spares. It's fine. Okay, right. We're back in the game. So let's pop this down. This is going to go horribly wrong. Oh. I'm definitely taking damage. All right, so it looks like that's the way that it enchants towards it, because it says in the book, doesn't it, that where is it, somewhere around it, So why don't you enchant your pieces that way? So instead you should enchant pearls directly, as recommended you enchant them inside a mirror, as they will then have a bias to a specific enchantment helping you out. So I'm guessing that because this guy has an elemental effect of Inferno, if we were to enchant it that way, we would get additional Inferno-y stuff on it, I guess. Yeah. So, it looks like it's very much hit and miss as far as the enchants that we can go. So I might have to set up some sort of XP farm so I can get a buttload of XP, and then I can enchant away until I get the pearls that I actually want. So I want the ones that give me the fire resistance. That's the main ones that I want. Fire resistance, and there is another one called Midas Touch, which, I believe it's something like Midas Touch, right at the back, where, orange, gold. Killing entities drop gold nuggets. Well, that's pretty cool, isn't it? So I need to get this elemental affinity on one of the pearls, and then we can have this enchant dependent on the color of the pearls that we use. So we've got things like black for bonus attack damage at night, blue for immune to drowning damage, digging dirt provides bait. It's good if you're going to be doing your fishing. Killing entities drops gold nuggets, which is just awesome. Immunity to poison, awesome. Orange, bonus XP on kills. So all of these are really good. We just need to keep basically enchanting pearls. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to enchant a load of pearls first before I make any of the jewelry. And then we can make the jewelry with the pearls that we have. I think that's probably going to be a better way of doing it. So I need to set up an XP farm to get all of the XP to be able to do the enchanting. And then we'll go through some pearls and we'll try and enchant them to see what we get. And if we get the ones I'm after, then I'll make jewelry out of them. I think that's a much better way of doing it. We've kind of done it a bit backwards because I didn't really understand it too great. So that's going to be my plan, yeah. So hopefully between this and the next episode, I should have some pretty cool jewelry to show you guys off. I'm going to do some Botania probably in the next episode as well, because I want to change this whole system around. I want to make it much bigger. I'm going to move it off over that way, and the chances are I want to have the 1.6 update on the server by then as well, the Age of Adventure 1.6, which has all the Alphamancy stuff in it as well, so maybe we can look into some of those cool bits and bobs. But yeah, there we go, guys. I'll see you soon for another episode. Have yourself a great day, have a good one, as always, and goodbye.